So you've just bought a Mercedes and are learning all the buttons, but what on earth does this symbol do on the dashboard? And why does it go grey and green at different times? Hey guys, Nick O'Leary here, and today we're looking at some live examples on the road of what this extremely clever and sophisticated system can do, and why, if you're not aware of it, could give you a bit of a shock. So as you may have gathered from the title of the video, it's called Active Lane Keeping Assist, and the word active plays an important part, but more on that in a minute. From researching online, it looked like the Mercedes Actros truck first utilised this sort of tech, and in its most basic form, assisted with keeping drivers in their lane by warning either through sound or vibration. Fast forward to today, and many cars like the A-Class, B-Class, GLA and CLA, and quite a few more on Mercedes now feature this kind of tech as standard. And the word active, lane keeping assist, that word active means the car can actively do something if the situation presents itself. Most Mercedes today that have this facility feature a camera here at the top of the windscreen. Now, it's not a camera that records or even produces an image that we can see. It's designed to look for white lines and sometimes objects in front, like a car. One thing to note as well, it's active from approximately 37 miles an hour to 124 miles an hour. And while scanning the lines, if it detects the car drifting over a lane like this, because you might have been distracted or not paying attention, it can do one or two things in this situation. So it can either rumble the steering wheel, or in some cases can actually use the brakes to jolt you back into lane. So these two situations, if you're driving down the road, for example, and you crossed a white line marking in the road, so like this one here on the right hand side, if you cross that one, you can get a kind of rumble on the steering wheel, just kind of warning you you're going over that line marking. However, it also does something different. Now, depending on the situation on the road, if you cross a solid white line marking, and potentially if there's cars coming towards you, it can actually brake the opposite side of the car to jolt you back into lane. Now, I use the term jolt for a reason, because it really is a jolt. So if you're not expecting it, it will definitely get your attention back to the road. And the whole idea is that if you, of course, like drift over a lane marking, these systems can obviously just help you stay within that lane, and obviously with other road users, they know where you are, you're meant to be in your lane and that sort of thing. So let's have a look at a few live examples of when this system actually kicks in. So now guys, first up, the dashed white line marking. So you won't really be able to see this too much because I will feel it on the steering wheel, but if I go over that white line marking without indicating, I can feel it. Oh yeah, there, I feel it vibrating on here on the steering wheel, just letting me know that I'm going over it. It's quite clever how that works. It must be some kind of vibrational thing in the steering wheel somewhere. So what about the white line marking? Well, what we'll do, we'll find a quiet road for this because I don't want people to think that I'm a careless driver or anything. This is purely just for the intent of this video, but I'm just gonna drift over a white line marking. I'll just find a quiet road and we'll show you what it does. So here we go then guys, this is the solid white line marking. So we have a solid line here on the left and no cars around. So I'm gonna drift over to the left lane here. Ready, oh, there we go. See, flags up on the screen saying, hey, you've just gone over that lane, and it brakes one side. And you probably heard that sound. It's basically just the brakes going on. It just kind of jolts you back in lane. So it's obviously just something to be aware of, because if you are not used to it, it can, you know, it can give you a bit of a shock. So what happens if you need to overtake someone, you know, a car, or maybe you need to overtake a cyclist or something like that? Well, this is where the Mercedes-Benz tech is quite clever. It will let you do that. You know, you are in full control of the car at all times. However, this road is quite a good example of that in action. As we go onto this road, it's a 30, as you can see, so it won't be active till 37 miles an hour. But look, there is a cycle lane on both sides of the road. And look, to get down this road, you can see the car coming towards me, this person has to drive on the cycle lane, and I have to drive on the cycle lane as well to go down this road. It's a weird road, I don't know why it's like that, but anyway, I have to drive down this road over the white line, but the car's not doing anything. And even in a minute, when I get to the 40 bit, when it'll be active, because obviously it's grey at the moment, it still won't do anything because I'm intentionally driving over that lane. The way this works is, it will only do it when you drift over a lane marking. So if you intentionally drive over a white line marking to get out of the way or something, like an emergency, or you need to overtake someone, if you drift over, then it could do that. But if you intentionally drive over, like, you know, driving swiftly out over the white line marking, then it won't do it. So literally here, we've got a 40 mile per hour speed sign just around the corner. There we go. So going up to 40, driving at 40, and still, you know, I'm go over to the right here, back over to the left, it won't do anything because there isn't another white line marking on the road. It's not clear. Even though it will sometimes go grey or green, it knows. It's quite clever how it can figure that out. So all that's well and good, but what happens if you want to turn it off or adjust its sensitivity? So let's show you how to do that now. So then guys, to adjust some settings on active lane keeping assist, basically on your multimedia screen, if you go all the way across to settings on the far right hand side, then go into the assistance menu, and then second one down, you see there, active lane keeping assist. So if you go in here, you've got a few things to choose from standard, sensitive, off, and then there's warning as well down there. So standard is what you've seen today. Basically, more often than not, it's going to do the rumbling of the wheel if you go over white line markings and that sort of thing. But if you choose sensitive, it will do the braking or the jolting back into lane more often. So use your preference on that one, I guess. There is also the option to turn it off, but this is something to be aware of, as this is classed as a safety system. So things like active lane keeping assist, parking sensors, ESP, also known as electronic stability program, the one that stops the wheels from spinning. These are all classed as safety systems, meaning they always default to on when you turn the car off and turn it back on. So when you turn the ignition off, get out, and then when you get back in, they will be back to on again. So no, there is no way to turn off active lane keeping assist permanently. So, you know, if you do want to turn it off, you will need to turn it off per driving session. But I will add, if you do, of course, have this on, and you need to overtake someone, if you drift over a lane marking and kind of do it slowly, you know, that could, you know, either rumble the wheel or jolt you back into lane. But of course, if you drive over intentionally, then it won't. But if you do use your indicator, so either just tapping it once and it'll do three flashes, or you keep it up and hold it there as you perform the overtaking maneuver or something like that, it actually turns off active lane keeping assist completely. So then you can perform that maneuver no problem, and then when you're back in lane, it will come back on again. So yes, it does turn it off here temporarily if you use your indicators, but then of course if you turn it off with the off button there, just remember that it will default back to on when you get back in the car after when you go to drive again. I guess the final thing on there then, guys, is the warning thing. That just shows you the image on the screen when you have gone over the lane marking. So if you have that on, which I think they always are defaulted to on, it will show you this kind of image on the screen here. So there we go, guys, that is active lane keeping assist found on Mercedes-Benz. So if you want to know more about your car, check this playlist out right here, as this one has every single tutorial I've ever made on Mercedes-Benz. So check that one out there if you want to know more. Guys, thank you so much for watching. Huge shout out to these guys, Sandown Mercedes-Benz, as they help provide access to all these awesome cars you see in the videos. Until next week, see you then.